Welcome to the evening Bible study. I love church. That is why I left my home around 9:30. I'm still in the church because I love the church. And then, beautiful ladies, you love the church. You live in the church. Hallelujah. You can sing it together. 369. What a friend we have in Jesus. Romans chapter 8. There's only one verse. Romans chapter 8, verse 28. Romans 8, 28 is a very famous scripture. Romans 8, 28. And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love Him, who have been called according to His purpose. You know, God wants working together for good. Two kind of people, conditional, those who love God and those who receive the calling of the Lord. All things, in all things, God works for the good of those who love God, love Jesus, love Holy Spirit, and who has been called according to His purpose, those who receive the calling of the Lord. Two things working together for good. Do you love Jesus? Yeah? Mm-hmm. You love Jesus? Do you believe that you have calling? Yeah? You don't know calling. I know you are a child of God. I know you are a missionary. I know you are a mighty man and woman of God. You have a calling. If you know two things, if you know your two things, I am a child of God. I love Jesus. And we need to know. We know all things. We know that all things working together for good. For good. Thank God he's on the way and the car, he's on the way to come here. The car broke down. And his wife and children went back to the home by train. He's still in here. And then that day, tomorrow he goes to Birmingham together with us. Can you imagine? The whole thing's working together for good. But I was inspired. He loved, God spoke to him by a number. God spoke to him by 2 to 2 in Korea. But in here again, his car broke down. Do you know which address? Number 222. It's very, very interesting. And I believe that God already spoke him very clearly. That means his cup of time means now you want to work in this place, in this area. He will come back to UK, he's working in this area. It's not wonderful, because God spoke to him very clearly. He was in the car. He stayed there for 4 hours in front of, you know, people that pushed the car and in front of the hairdressing shop. And then, you know, I arrived there around 7:30. When I arrived there, he pushed somebody's door. Every door is, you know, locked in this time. But the hairdressing shop open. I said, what happened? The people in the hairdressing shop give them tea and food, and then you can use the toilet. Door is open for him. They look like angels. And I get the leaflet, and then, because wife is Roman Catholic, we share the goodness of Lord Jesus. But can you imagine, he just arrived there. In London, there's not many, you know, the shop is open. Because already Sunday is closed.
Yeah.
They come from the holiday. But when they saw him and his wife and children, they have compassionate to supporting for this family. He stopped for 4 hours, more than 4 hours, stay there. And one thing we do know, all things working together for what?
Good.
For good. For good. Especially if you are a born again Christian, if you love Jesus. All things working together for good. Do you know how I get married? My wife, Eunju. Korean name is Eunju, English name is Deborah. And then, you know, God spoke to me in 1996, you're going to engage in this year, 1996. Which means, I also prayed to God for my wife. I prayed for 7 years. 7 years is a, you know, final year. And God spoke to me, not only engage, you're going to marry in 1996. I married on the 7th of December, 1996. But in May, 1996, in May, you will engage. And then, I was very excited because God spoke to me and you engaged. And then I told my friend and our congregation, I go to Korea to engage. People, they are curious. Who is your fiancé? I say to them, the Lord will prepare for me. The Lord will provide for me. Do you know what they say? That is why you are a Pentecostal pastor. Because, you know, you don't know who is the person, but you're going to stay in Korea for 1 month. But within 1 month, you find that the woman to engage is a nonsense. It's impossible. But I know the three people. I told you, among the three, one of the lady will be my wife. And my wife, my mother told me, one lady, she is a graduate from Bible College. She's a pastor, and she's a wonderful woman of God. Actually, my mother told me that woman is like Miss Korea, beautiful. Beautiful, and then she called me Miss Korea. I think she'll be your wife. My mother told me, but once a month she come to my mother's house. She prepared the food and clean the house once a month. And I thought, you know, the young man all the time looking for good-looking woman. You know, all the men is saying, African men, and European men, Korean, everybody saying, how about you? Every man looking for good looking woman. And then because of my mother told me, Miss Korea, and she showed me showed me the photo. It's very nice, beautiful. And then I told my mother when I arrived in Korea, give me her number. She said she hasn't got the number. There's no mobile for time. She hasn't got the number of her telephone number. Oh, I don't know. She asked you when she's coming to home. She said she doesn't know. But once a month she'll come anyway. And then she doesn't know. My mother never know. And then I asked him, Lord, I'm going to open the door for 1 week. If that woman come to my mother's house, I stay in my mother's house, read the Bible and fasting and pray. Because I'm very excited to see her and get married. I open the door. If anybody come, I open. Nobody come. Not that lady. 7 days I waited. That woman never come. I said to you, now hear this now. Father, I thank you. She is not my wife. Thank you, Jesus. And then, you know, what was that? I never seen her physically. But even when I get married, before I arrive in my mother's house, she's the one to come and prepare all the food also. She's look like angel. I don't know. I don't remember her name or something. And then she's not. Another woman, do you know, that woman, the lady, she's a wonderful Christian. But because of she has got the nursery school, and she's a well-known, and she's an effective woman. She loved to get married. And then she waited for me 2 years and 1 year continually. But 1 year ago, when I met her, she told me, Pastor Paul, one man, young man, continually follow me because of not Jesus come to church. Because of me, he come to the church. She told me. And then 1 year later, I think, because one lady is gone now, maybe this woman. I prayed to the Holy Spirit, spoke to me, tell her she need to release from you. And I told her, I asked him, is that man still come to the church because of you? And she said, yes. And I told her, I think the will of God for you, you need to get married with that man. She was crying. Her heart is relief because she was confusing. Mm-hmm. And then she married with that man. Second is gone. And third, one lady, her father is a pastor, her mother is a pastor, like and that lady, she speaks English very well, and she's a lawyer, and then everything, she finished at the UN University, she's doing well. But when I talk to her, she's not totally devoted to Jesus. She believes in Jesus, she goes to church, but not to be a pastor's wife, not missionary wife. And then I say to God, Lord, I think it's not that woman. I was disappointed. God spoke to me very clearly, in May 1996, you will engage. But I didn't see. And do you know what was said for me? And I disappointed. And then I went to the Gimpo Airport. At the time, Gimpo, not Incheon. Gimpo Airport. When I arrived there, guess what was happening? I missed the flight. First time in my life I missed the flight. When I check it, 2 hours ago, the flight is gone. I missed the flight. I check in, next one is 2 days later. But I was so ashamed, where shall I stay in Korea? I don't want to stay in Seoul. I know the one prayer mountain in Gangwon-do. I called, if you don't mind, can I go to your prayer mountain and stay there for 2 days? My flight 2 days later and I fly. She said, yeah, you can come. When I went there, and the director of the prayer mountain, she asked me, did you pray to God for your future wife? I said, yes. She knew my heart. Yes, I pray about that. And she said to me, I have the 2 boys and 1 daughter. Do you want to see my daughter? Because I already disappointed. And then, okay, let me see. And then she come to the room, and you went to the prayer mountain. And then, I'm not in the detective, but just, hello, how are you? But Holy Spirit spoke to me, ask a question. Because these are 3 ladies, they are not possible to ask you that question. Well, God-given question. This is a God-given question. I spoke to her, what do you think? I may die for Jesus. And she think about that and she said to me, I will support him for you to die for Jesus. When she spoke, oh, my tears rolling on my face. If somebody give the right answer, God spoke to me, she'll be your wife. But Eunju, she gave the right answer. I never knew. God prepared my wife in the prayer mat, in Gangwon-do. At the time, 5 hours, 5 and 6 hour journey, long journey from Seoul to there. If I didn't miss the flight, I never met.
Yeah.
Miss the flight, is it good news or bad news? Good news. Look like bad news. That is meaning all things, in all things working together for good. And then I told her we're going to marry this year. And then, which is 1996, I came back to Korea, England. And then I told my mother and my father, all my family, I sent a photo. I'm going to marry this woman. And then, whatever I say, all my family, they believe, because they respect me very much from my family. Why? Because they become a born-again Christian through me. They respect me. And then, before the 10 days of the wedding ceremony, I arrived in Korea, and I brought my wife to show all my family, and I married on the 7th of December. But the Gangwon-do and my mother's place, Suncheon, is a 13 hours journey. 13 hours, and we think about where is the best place to go to Suncheon or Gangwon-do. For me, it is Seoul. We married in Seoul. And it was a heavy, snowing day. And then I told my wife, first night is for Jesus. After the wedding ceremony, we pray all night. She agreed. We pray all night on Saturday and attend the Sunday service. And then on Monday morning, we go to Philippines, honeymoon. And because some of our Filipino members, they arrange for hotel, everything. We stayed there 10 days. And I told my wife, because she's supporting for me to die for Jesus, I told her she is a woman soldier for Jesus. I'm a man soldier. Two soldiers meet together for what? To fight against the enemy. And then when you arrive in Philippines, and I went to a Christian bookshop and to buy the leaflet. And when I arrived there, and then the manager of a Christian bookshop, why you come here? And I want to buy the leaflet for Christian gospel to evangelize. And then sure, but I told him I come here for honeymoon. But your honeymoon couple want to preach the gospel. She was so inspired. She gave the 500 leaflet free of charge. And I was preaching on the street. My wife gave the leaflet in Philippines in honeymoon time. And over 150 people surround in the street. And one guy, he came to me. Would you like to lead the conference in our church? He's a pastor in the church. I come here for honeymoon. I think no for conference. But he begging me. I say okay. I do it for 3 nights. But 300 members in Filipino, but it's Stone Church. I was preaching in there. But one member in the Filipino church, no member, Korean attended the church. The Koreans came to me, if you don't mind, can you lead in the Korean service? Korean conference. I said, no, I come here for honeymoon. I don't conference. But the Korean guy begging me, please, 3 months ago, our Korean church divide. Around 40-40. They Koreans, they're hiring the Filipino church. 3 months ago divide. They begging me. I say no, but I give option. If you two group argue each other. If you two group come to the morning service, morning conference, it's a 2-day morning conference, 3 night. Morning conference, I can do it, but option, you have to come. All these people, 80 people need to come. Otherwise, I don't want to do it. They discuss each other, the other group, and they want to do it. Do you know how they do? How they sit? One group in this side, another group this side. I never ever seen in my life the face is so ugly. Everybody angry and then terrible. Because of 3 months ago the church division. But they just sit like this. Guess what was happening? When I was preaching in there, the spirit of repentance come upon them. Everybody weeping and crying. Over 70-80 people, they kneel down and pray. Guess what was happening? They reconciled again, they become one church again. I think when I go to heaven, I think there's some reward for me. I went to the Philippines for my honeymoon, but God used me to reconcile in one church in Philippines. I thanks be to God. But why I say like this, according to Romans 8, verse 28, in all things, working together for good. Praise God, your car broke down. Pastor, what's wrong with you? Car broke down, you're happy? No, this is not my point. Only the God spoke to you. When his car broke down, and God spoke to you very clearly, you're going to work in this area. Especially his car is broke down in front of the number 222. Holy Spirit spoke to me today for his three children. give the 20 pound, three of them, 20, 20, 20. this afternoon. Can you imagine? But for me, I don't know how God speaks. God spoke to me through visions and dreams, and even audible voice or the word of the Lord. But God spoke to me very clearly, especially by numbers. It's different. Everybody is different. But God spoke to him. Therefore, tonight, I came here. You know, I need to go back to the car again with him. I'm going to have a quick dinner, and I'll go there. But what is my point? In all things, working together for good. Those who love Jesus. Those who has got the calling of God. Yeah, open to Romans 8:28. We know, you know, I know. In all things, God works for good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your grace and your mercy. We know that all things working together for good because we love Jesus, because we have been called to according to his purpose. Father, we love you. Bless your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for watching. God bless you. Have a wonderful evening.